Supplying 10,000 times the world's total energy, the sun is a natural light bulb that shines through our lifetime. But on the flip side, it harbors dangerous regions that could possibly send us back to the Stone Age within minutes. Just recently, scientists have found a monstrous sunspot called the AR3038, and it is pointed right at Earth. How come it got so big, and what will be the consequences? Well, join us in today's video and let's find out. A solar flare is an intense burst of radiation coming from the release of magnetic energy associated with sunspots. Flares are our solar system's largest explosive events. They are seen as bright areas on the sun and they can last for minutes to hours. We typically see a solar flare by the photons or light it releases and most every wavelength of the spectrum. The primary way we monitor flares are in X-rays and optical light. Flares are also sites where particles like electrons, protons, and heavier particles are accelerated. You can think of it like the twisting of rubber bands, Rob Steinberg said. If you have a couple of rubber bands twisted around on your finger, they eventually get twisted too much and they break. The difference with magnetic fields is that they reconnect. And when they reconnect, it's in that process that a flare is generated. Aside from being a very impressive phenomenon as northern lights, aka aurora borealis, a solar storm's particles are no joke. Their temperature is ranging between 10 to 20 million Kelvin. A single solar flare can start with an explosion nearly equal to millions of nuclear bombs together on the surface of the sun. Hence, cosmic scientists monitor and classify solar flares based on brightness in X-rays and optical light. C-class flares are the smallest type of solar flares that can exist, and their impact on Earth is considered insignificant. Next in line are M-class flares, which fall in the medium-sized category. Their impact is generally more significant than C-class flares, but they can only cause minor radiation storms at worst. The X-class flares are the biggest category of solar flares. Of all the categories, the X-class poses the most threats to Earth, with potential devastating effects that could cause serious problems for humanity in many areas. A single X-class eruption can destroy our sophisticated satellites, electric power grids, and communications infrastructure. If that were to happen, NASA would have to shut down the International Space Station and all space missions to prevent astronauts from suffering serious radiation. There would be no TV, radio, or internet. It's needless to say that you wouldn't even be watching this video. Such a storm would literally send us back to the Stone Age within minutes. As we are in an active solar phase, which will most likely peak in 2025, upcoming bursts are expected, but the danger they pose can't be predicted. On a cosmic scale, the AR3038 has quite a big chance of reaching this stage, and even more of being in the M-class already. The scariest thing about this particular spot is that it doubled its size in 24 hours, currently reaching 19,800 miles, and is located around the sun's equator. Exactly at the worst place for us, as this region produces the most flares in the past. The enormous energy that is discharged into the upper atmosphere when a solar burst happens can heat up gases and increase the drag on our satellites. Thankfully, solar flares of this kind don't erupt every day. Astronomers have known since 1775 that solar activity rises and falls according to a roughly 11-year cycle. But recently, the sun has been more active than expected, with nearly double the sunspot appearances predicted by National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. In February 2022, SpaceX launched 49 Starlink satellites, but unfortunately for the Elon Musk-owned company, a solar flare occurred, causing atmospheric drag to rise by at least 50%. As a result, 40 satellites lost their way completely. The aerospace company immediately commanded the satellites into safe mode, where they would fly edge-on like a sheet of paper to minimize drag. But still, they were unable to steer the satellites to their orbit. In a statement, SpaceX said, preliminary analysis show the increased drag at the low altitudes prevented the satellites from leaving safe mode to begin orbit-raising maneuvers, and up to 40 of the satellites will re-enter or already have re-entered the Earth's atmosphere. Back in September 1859, British sky watcher Richard Joseph Carrington discovered the world's most violent solar flare eruption by chance. An unexpected glint of light appeared when he observed the sun. Carrington wasn't certain what it was, but he described it as a white light flare. That particular one had an X-ray peak of X45 and was rightfully named the Carrington Event. The whole discovery episode only lasted for 5 minutes, but the impact would go on to impact the world for weeks, causing severe damage. The world's telegraph communication system was disrupted, with several telegraph machines and printing papers reportedly catching fire. There were reports of operators being electrocuted as well. Colorful auroras lit up the night skies, even in Cuba. They are reported to be so bright that birds were convinced that it was dawn of a new day, and they came flying out of their nests. And it would have been possible to read a newspaper by the night sky. According to analysis, the Carrington solar flare is the largest ever recorded by scientists, ejecting the same energy as 10 billion 1 megaton atomic bombs. But is it possible that the AR-38 reached this level? So far, the gigantic AR-3038 is about 3 times as big as the size of our Earth and is currently 2,000 degrees Celsius cooler than the neighbouring area of the Sun's surface. According to the latest footage from NASA's Solar Dynamics Observatory, it continues to twist, contort, and grow day by day. Yesterday, sunspot AR-3038 was big. Today, it's enormous, stated by experts of the field just recently. However, Rob Steinberg, the acting lead of the Space Weather Forecast Office, says, "This is not an unusual occurrence. This is what sunspots do," Rob said. "Over time, generally, they'll grow. They go through stages and then they decay." Other experts, however, are quite shocked about the size and the fast growth of the area, as well as the unexpected solar activity at this stage. Alex Young added that the solar flare is currently discharging small solar flares and does not have the complexity for the largest flares. However, there's still a slight chance that it might metamorphose into an enormous one. By his calculation, there's a 30% chance the sunspot will produce medium-sized flares and a 10% chance it will create large flares. For sure, these numbers are not enormously big. However, they should not be taken lightly. Luck is much needed when it comes to serious solar flares. For instance, the planet in Proxima Centauri's habitable zone got busted by a huge flare a few years ago. The event came out of the blue and served as a wake-up call for scientists of the field. If we were to reside there, mankind would have passed into history. Considering the fact that there are 100 billion stars in the Milky Way, we better watch out.